Alright, what's up, you guys? This is Evil Boss here, and we're here Michael's Mario deck profile for Post Breakers of Shadow. So, yeah, let's get on to it.
Alright, so I play 3 Megalo. This is very essential for the deck. It's very good for OTKs, and there's no reason not to run 3. I play 1 Abyssteus. I only play 1 because you don't really have that many search targets in the deck to search for. It's really good for only rank 7 plays, and that's about it. And then I still play the 1 lead. This is really good just for the beat stick and the rank 7 access. Then I play only 1 Pike and 1 Turge. Pike isn't really that great this format because you have Neptibus, and Turge is just there to get back Neptibus, and you only play 1-1 for the occasional rank 4 play or the end phase Turge-Pike combo if you want to. Then I play 2 Gund and 1 Lind. So 3 Gund isn't that great this format, or great in general, and 1 Gund is not enough, so 2 is a perfect number. And Lind is really not that great because, you know, it has to be destroyed and then it gets the effect.
It's too slow.
Yeah, it's way too slow. So I only play 1 because it's still good at 1, but I wouldn't play more than that.
Yep.
So that's a Mermels.
Yep.
And then I play the MVP of the deck, Neptibus.
The most broken card in the deck.
Yeah, so this card, if you don't know, it's pretty much a +2. So you send an Atlantean to your grave and you add 1 to hand. And it's really good because it's essentially a 1-card OTK with your Megalo.
Yep.
Because, it's just really good. And with the Neptibuses, I play the 2 infantry, the 2 marksmen, and the 2 dragoons.
Pulses for days.
Yeah, so Neptibus usually sends dragoons and then adds any one of these, and then dragoons add a Megalo or something. And that's really good. And you do need to play a high count of Atlanteans because Neptibus needs 2 of them to go off. So because of that, I play the 1 Poseidra. So I've noticed that mostly in games, I would run out of targets for Neptibus with only playing 6. So I play the 7th Poseidra just so I don't actually run out.
Yep.
And Poseidra is also really good because Neptibus, when it's tributed or sent to the grave, you can actually summon a Poseidra back. And it's really good for OTKs, and it's really good for rank 7 plays.
Yep.
So essentially, Neptibus becomes a 1-card rank 7 play with Megalo, and that's because of Poseidra.
Those Octodragoons.
Yeah. Then I play the 1 D.Va. This is obvious. Just bring out Neptibus and then you win. Then I play the 1 Aqua Spirit. This is good because of the next card that I play, Mon Glacia. So this kind of regulates the cards in the grave for Mon Glacia. And it combos off really good with Dragoons too, because you can just go into like an Abyss Swell or a Bahamut Shark and activate the effect. And then the last monsters in the deck, I play 3 Maxi. This is just because, it's just because of this format, you need 3. And honestly, if you can draw cards and Mermels and still survive that turn, you pretty much have game next turn. And then going on to the spells, I play these 2 equip spells. I don't like Mikazuchi because it's not that great against Pendulums, because it negates a spell effect, not a spell activation. So you don't actually negate the activation of a Pendulum skill, and it doesn't destroy the Pendulum skill. So they still have the skill, so I'd rather just play these. This negates a trap, and this negates a monster effect. And the reason I play this is because OTK, because if your opponent doesn't have back row, or you can stop their back row, you win. And Kraken is just after your turn is over and you haven't OTK'd your opponent, and this is just good for their next turn to prevent them from like Castelling or whatever they're going to do. And then I play 1-for-1, obvious, for Neptibus, and it's also great with guns because you can use gun effect.
Yep.
Then I play 3 Instant Fusion. I play 3 because this is also the MVP in the deck besides Neptibus, because you just go Instant Fusion, get back Dragoons, then you can use Dragoons effect again.
Yep, yep, yep.
And this is really good. Baits out back row, and yeah, it's just broken. You hate back row in this deck, that's how you lose, so you play 3 Twin Twisters.
Yep.
I don't like MST that much, because to me, I would rather just pop more than just pop 1.
Yep.
And this also activates Guns effect, and you also have a lot of great discard outlets, because you're playing the Poseidra, you're playing the Guns, you're playing the lead, so you have a lot of discard outlets in the deck for Twin Twister. And yeah, it's also set up card too.
Yep.
And then the last spell, I play the one Rikeki. It's an OTK deck, so you want to, you know, get all those monsters off. So then I just play the 1 Sphere. In my opinion, Sphere isn't that great this format. It's too slow. So I only play 1 because it is searchable with Megalo. And because of that, so the 1 Sphere, the 1 Lind is all you really need. And then I play the Bottomless, Treacherous, and Nightmare. I play this because I play Rafflesia in the extra deck. And this would be a time space if I had one, but for now, this is all I'm running.
Do you like those traps?
These are really good. I wouldn't take these out. This would be a time space. It's all right. Today, I resolved this like 2 or 3 times, which was really good. But yeah, I would rather prefer a time space. And then last one is Warning.
That ulti.
If I had strikes, I wouldn't actually be running them, because you don't want to have too many traps in the deck, so I think Warning's just a better card to have. And yeah. So that's the main deck. It should be 40.
Should be
40. Yeah, it should be 40. And then for the extra deck, I play the two Nikos, you know, the two tokens. Yeah, shout out to Nico. Alright, then for the rank 7s, I play the Draco Sack. This card isn't that great anymore, but I still like it just for the defensive abilities. And with Tatsunoko, you can go into Trish with the tokens. Then I play the Big Eye. Big Eye is really good. I still really like it because of Poseidra and Megalo. It's still really easy to go into. And then Gaios and Flare Metal. This is obvious. I shouldn't really need to explain that. Flare Metal is just good in case your opponent plays back row heavy decks. This can't be destroyed by card effects, so that's why it's really good. Then I play Dweller. The main reason I actually play Dweller is just to get off the Dragoon's effect. I don't really care about Dweller effect. It's just the Dragoon's effect.
And also the attack boost.
Yeah. And then Castell is Castell. Rafflesia, this is just really good if you don't OTK and you want to set up like a defensive play. Then I play the Bahamut in straight. I still think this is very good. It's just also, if you don't have the Rafflesia to go into, this is also great.
Is it mandatory though?
Bahamut Shark to play? Not really. It's really not that great anymore. Mm-hmm. But it's just it's good for, you know, defensive. And it also activates Dweller's, not Dweller, Dragoon's effect if you wanted to.
Alright.
And then I play the two Noden. Playing three is stupid. Playing one is not enough. So you just play two. Then for the Synchros, I play Tatsunoko.
Now, how good is this card?
So this card, in my opinion, is really broken in this deck because of D.Va. So if you just D.Va into Neptibus, you just plus from there, then you Synchro into Tatsunoko. And Tatsunoko is good because it's very easy to go into Trish after you add whatever you added from there. And with D.Va, D.Va is a one-card Leo because D.Va send Neptibus. Neptibus, you know, send whatever, pop whatever. Let's say you pop a Marksman, right? And then you add Poseidra. You just go into Tatsunoko, and then Tatsunoko into go into Leo. So this card's really good because of that, and I would never take out this unless D.Va gets hit.
Do you think it's going to get hit?
No. It should go back up, you know? Yeah. And then I play the Herald. This card's really good for the mirror match because if you bring this out, your opponent can't actually summon anything because it banishes everything from the hand and main deck, whatever. But yeah, it's really good because, you know, D.Va and infantry can go into it. So it's very consistent. And usually I do this after I'm going in main phase 2 and not OTKing. Then I play Leo because Tatsunoko. Leo's really good against Cosmos if they don't have Honest, so that's why I'm playing that. And then Trish, one of the MVPs in the extra deck. I love Trish. Honestly, Noden is, besides Tatsunoko, Noden is essentially a one-card Trish. Because if you just go D.Va into Marksman, D.Va Marksman is Trishula right there. But one of the cool plays I actually found out was, so let me get these out of the way. So if you go D.Va, go into Neptibus. Neptibus just add, really doesn't matter what you add. But if you send the infantry, or send the Marksman to the graveyard, then you go Noden, bring back Marksman. You can just go into Trish right here, and you still have the Neptibus to tribute or do whatever. And then you have a Trish Neptibus on field. So Trish is so easy to summon in this deck, and there's no reason not to play it because of that.
You don't really minus going into Trish either.
That's the deck.
Okay, so how much do you like this deck?
I like this deck a lot. It really fits like how I play. The half of the deck searches for the other half of the deck, which is really nice. And because of this card being released, the deck is so consistent with only being one card. And yeah.
Alright. So yeah, that pretty much does it. That's Murmels. So this is Evil Boy signing out. Peace out, guys. Peace out.